A candidate for the Iowa Court of Appeals is questioned about her marriage vows. Critics are calling the question unusual and even inappropriate. KCCI's Laura Nichols explains why that one question is getting so much attention. Laura?
Stacy, Assistant Iowa Attorney General Jeannie Vout was asked if she was violating her marriage covenant vows. The question asked by State Judicial Nominating Commission member Scott Bailey violates the commission's policy and is raising a lot of eyebrows.
During her interview for the Iowa Court of Appeals, Jeannie Vout quickly addressed the speculation surrounding her and her husband, former state auditor David Vout.
You might have heard that my spouse is now employed 1,600 miles east of here in Norwalk, Connecticut. And when you heard that, you probably also heard that I was staying here. And you may have wondered to yourself during this process, why didn't she go with him?
Vout went on to say her ultimate goal is to be an Iowa Court of Appeals judge, and that's why she chose to stay. But it's the question that State Judicial Nominating Commission member Scott Bailey asked soon after that has critics talking.
Did you make covenant vows with your husband that you feel you have kept or that you're breaking?
Without skipping a beat, Vout responded that her husband is very supportive.
And he is 100% behind me in this endeavor, and I've always been 100% behind him.
Bailey, who was appointed to the commission by Governor Branstad, is a prominent Christian homeschooling advocate. Critics are calling his question unusual. The president of the Iowa State Bar Association, Guy Cook, had this to say, quote, giving the commissioner Bailey the benefit of the doubt, perhaps he was trying to explore the candidate's ethical compass. Regardless, if that was why the question was asked, there are far more appropriate questions to explore ethics of a candidate, in my experience.
Now, just before news time, I heard back from Scott Bailey today. He told me he simply was asking a clarifying question because Vout brought it up first and gave personal information about her decision not to follow her husband. Now, I reached out to Vout for an interview. Her response to me was one line. She said, quote, I attempted to answer all the questions commissioners posed to me to the best of my ability, unquote.
And Laura, any response from the governor's office since Governor Branstad appointed Bailey to this commission?
No, the governor's spokesperson told us no comment because he says he was not present during the deliberations.
Okay. Laura, thank you.